for saying and told, I have a scheme for the solution here. We are going to break it to three. And from there, like yesterday, we now talk about it, we discuss it, and we now see some of the way to overcome it. One of the recurring men that are new now, and they are not new, because if you consider Revelation chapter 2 and chapter 3, we discover that Jesus sent messages to churches, Ephesus, Thyatira, Pergamos, all those churches. And you discover that most of the things he said concerning those churches are still with us now. And one of it, you will see it, and we have seen it today. If a sermon is preached, we are blessed by the sermon. We are touched. We should leave some things out. If the text, the theme, and the theme and text we already know, if it's not repeated, what do we do? But I also noticed that the first two that commended the preacher were his ordination mates. You see, that is synergy. That is holding up our brothers. So that before you people fire you, you're already defended. And none of us can go outside that skin. Thank you, God. They are still together. Praise the Lord. Now we want to go into the real thing. All of us must talk. Brother Aluagbe mentioned something in the course of the sermon. He mentioned something about the Geneva Convention. And in the Geneva Convention, it has to do, there's a convention held in Geneva. I don't want us to be bothered about the time, the date, or whatever. But there are some things mentioned about combat and combatants in that convention. And not one of the major things mentioned. The Geneva Convention spoke about the rules of engaging in war. Now, he mentioned something there, that in warfare or during warfare, the combatant must be ready to die. The combatant must be ready to die. And went further to say, not just dying, but dying for the civilian. So, when combatants are in war, they are not there because of the dollars they are going to get. They are there because they are going to die protecting the civilians who are sleeping at home. Now, note another thing from the Geneva Convention. It says, any soldier, either volunteer or uniform, who runs away from the battle must be sentenced to death. There is this thing, I like it in the Bible, or your love or your tomorrow. But there is a particular stanza there that has to do with my name. And each time they sing it, or I sing it, or I see it, it has a way of touching me. Only, I will get some. So when we are talking about being combatants, three major things are important. the ministry in which you are called to, your home, and the relationship between you and your colleagues. I said colleagues, and I asked you to remove one question yesterday. And the question was, you and your colleagues, you and your relationship, are you friends? I asked you to remove it. Now, the reason why I asked you to remove it is this. You are not friends. You are not friends. You are colleagues. I know some people will query it, but don't worry, I will explain. Now let's go to how we overcome the elements. We all know the elements. We know them. I tried to itemize some yesterday, and others have brought out some, and many of us even have some in our mind. Now, how can we overcome it? Let's go to the question of ministry. Whose call did you yield to? Let me hear a close answer. Whose call did you yield to? Call of whom? God. God called you, Abby. I was not there when he called you. He called you, maybe in your dream or wherever. And by the time we go for selection conference, some of us did orishirishi. I just saw myself in white pastor, I saw myself on the pulpit preaching. And I saw myself in front of many people and was saying, whatever you call this, but you have agreed that God has called you. But you know that some of us call ourselves. Do you know that some of us answer conditional calls? Dobati, yes. Dobati, yeah, give up. I get out. And the call is not a call for better, for stay, for worse, for get out. Now, let's see the second question. Whose strength and knowledge are you using? Whose strength and knowledge are you using? There should be a chorus answer. God's knowledge and strength. Now, in that God's knowledge, it will break it down to a sequence: application, introduction, conclusion, text, theme, habit. But note one thing, some of us, because of our exposure, because of our experience, we tend to use our knowledge. And we tend to use wisdom that is different from the wisdom of God. Baba Adukope, you will remember the kema applied by Solomon. Some of us at a point, God will use us. And at a point, God will tell you, no, that place is a local area. But because we are interested in that area, we want to go. And we will use our past knowledge and our past experience. And the bishop will say, okay, go there. And by the time we get there, we start to use our own knowledge and understanding. And before you know it, it won't go well. God will give us understanding. Whose recommendation are you following? This is where we are going. Whose recommendation are you following as by your God? I know several of us say recommendation of God. Where did God give you that recommendation? If God says you are the vicar, or God says you are a panel, or he says you are a deacon, or he says you are an archdeacon, or he says you are a bishop, how did he say it? We are to be saved. We are heading somewhere. Look at the next one. Who are you accountable to? And I know you will give me a chorus answer. God. Now, go back to that recommendation. Whose recommendation are you following? Where are we of them? Yes, you are called, but where are you of them? Who ordained you? How were you ordained? You look at it seriously at times, you discover that you are in between God and the bishop. You now start to look at yourself the way it is. I read the word of God, and the word of God is saying, this is how you should be. And the bishop said, this is what I want you to do there. You now get to the gospel. In that situation, what do you do? In that situation, how do you go about it? We are talking about amen. Don't forget. But you realize one thing. One of the major amen. Of course, you see it is name, but it is not really name. It's fear. Fear. Imagine calling to me, you very well now. That is ministry. Now, let's talk about our relationship. I remember I mentioned your colleague is not your friend, but it's your colleague. Now, let us talk. How did we become oga to that person that we are oga to? How did we become common chef to that person that we are common chef to in the ministry? You discover that somebody somewhere in one office with one statutory power just gave you are the leader, and you become the leader. And that same person told another person older than you or younger than you are the assistant priest, and the two of you became. Am I making any? Somebody made you the leader. It is not you that became the assistant priest. Somebody made you the assistant priest. Now the two of you will now work together. How do you work together? But the day that you see yourself as bigger, That is very big, that have problems, it's a serious problem. And the day you start to see yourself as assisting me, that is the day you start to have a problem, it's a serious problem. Two elements will be visible there. One, superiority complex. The second one, inferiority complex. And the two major things that will come out of that inferiority complex and superiority complex, let me tell you. For superiority complex, you now look at the hair, we have arrived. I'm in charge. Another thing is, I am better than him. That is why I am here. So whatever gift that man is going to manifest, I will suppress him. Mr. Vicar, look at it very well. If that is assisting priest, Gio Kulide, they won't mention the Manilia, Oko, Benedicto, Lambaga, or Reverend Daniel Kamelu, or Reverend Lakashevi, or Gio Kulide in church. That will be glory after God. It will be recorded. But you won't want him to choke in the show that the magician will not say, you're in the only fire. Fire don't only, the fire is from you. God is only manifesting some of the things that he has deposited in you through that man. He can never be above you if you realize it. Now for the assisting priest, major event is of neighbor. Inferiority complex. And look at what will happen in that inferiority complex. You don't even know how to do it before the bishop. That is why I have placed us all down this one. Well, is your not before? Let me just see. At least if the assessment or not, I will get my statement. You will laugh. And all the gifts that you have had, you keep it to yourself, waiting for the day you become the vicar and you'll be in charge, and you may not become the vicar. Hello. Do I mention instances of those that have not become the vicar? And they have been ordained before us. They can be mentioned. You know them. It is not because they are limited. No. It's because someone in one office has told me that says, assisting priest here. So why are we stopping this? All these complex are serious ailments, canker war that is eating deep to this ministry. I pray God will give us understanding. Now, let's go back to the beginning of your goal.
I told you that.
Who is accountable in your marriage? Dr. Alade, who is accountable in your marriage? Are you sure? From your doctoral experience, you are both accountable. Okay, no problem. Baba,
divided.
in a football team, somebody will be from the north and is a Fulani, another person from the Niger Delta, another person from the east, another person from the southwest, and they are the same football pitch. You realize that? Now, how do they relate when you come to play that game? They may not know themselves or other. In other words, they are not friends. Let us look at our application. I am from Abeokuta. This Baba is from Malaysia. Domicile in Abeokuta. One way or the other, from Abeokuta to the beginning, we have never met before until 2006 when I was in India. We've been working together. Are we friends? We are not friends. He doesn't know me from another lawyer. When you talk about friends, that means you will be liable for what that man does if you say he's your friend. But let us see the guy and assisting this relationship. They are not friends, they are colleagues. That is why if the assistant priest commits any error, it is that assistant priest that will go for it, not the bigger. But if you are friends, you are liable for what your friend commits. And if you back to your head, I'm away to get. So let's get that straight. We are team workers. We work together to achieve what? A common goal. Now, take note of this thing. We are all combatants. Combatants. So when the soldiers on the field, on the battlefield, when they line up, when it is time for them to fight, to lay flat on the floor, they lay flat on the floor. Why? Because there are some other soldiers at the back that are going to shoot. They have long-range guns. And by the time some set are lying back, those sets are falling on their belly to move from. But note one thing. If any of them that is falling make any mistake to stand up, what happens to him? In Papua and Papua. So the battle we are fighting as priests is the battle that must be fought together. So if you not stay clear against one another, you will not win that game. Let me give you an instance. 1994, Nigeria won the Nations Cup. Rashidi Yekini became the highest goal scorer at that Nations Cup, and it was rejoicing. They gave him their call. He did not acknowledge his teammates. He said, I am the best. They got to walk up. He netted the first goal for Nigeria and he went to the net. And the police were there to believe him. He ignored them. And one of them called him. The other supported Amunike and Amoka. Oh, you thought you had the one that scored the goal at me? You will know you are not the one. They knew him. They knew his ability. That the only time, the best time for Rashidi Yekini to score a goal is when you cross for him and you not. Or when you give him a play ball and he's able to run that time or he cannot move to the ball. Different techniques, different style. He can, Rashidi Yekini cannot go to ball and move with him. But when you throw the ball, he may move fast, he will run out of the field and beat him there. He will throw the passing to him. He will be there. you are only on the way yourself. That is the same thing you must not do. You will die in stress. When you tell me, go and prepare the day before you come to your place, sir, you go back to the back and start to the stuff. And by the time you get there, you will not do this. You will not do this. Sorry. You will do it yourself, or you will do it together. Because when you finish the service, nobody will hammer you. Even when they hammer you, you are the one they are hammering. That's why it's not me. You are doing yourself. But when you have good rapport, good relationship with your priest in your attitude, you know about their welfare. We have had so many attitudes in this house. They will ask after your children. They know the name of your children, one after the other. Have you ever thought about school? Then they go, oh, they won't look at your mistake. You will not come back to the head. Oh, she believes you. You know the man. But someday around you, they want you to do the work. Children of God, we are talking about amens. Some little things that will mar the ministry for us. If we are not careful. Now let me use that with that one. Somebody drop this one. When you have issues with your colleague, you get home to go and discuss it with your wife. I mentioned it briefly yesterday. You are not actually being big fire on one another in the office. When you get home, have a fire. The man will go so easy. Look here. Your wife will take the battle upon himself, upon herself. Your wife will fight your guy to the level you will not like. Because women are like that. They are protective of their husbands. Even if the husband is beating her, the husband is not living with money. But you just want to fight your husband, you will see the other eye of your man. The woman will fight you beyond what her husband will fight. Then when you now set you with your guy, with the woman said, because the woman will have fought two battles. You will fight with your guy, fight with your guy's wife. Fight and you will instigate the children to fight with your guy's children. So by the time you are fighting with your guy, your wife will not send you, the children will not send you. They are going to chaos. And the two of you live in the same compound. And you are going to achieve the same goal. God will give us although these statements will feel they are new, but they have been there. But we can overcome them. Some people give recommendations. Let's go back to Mr. Aladdin's paper. Let's go back to Mr. Aladdin's paper of yesterday. When she was talking about prostitution, she gave some prayer. Are you there? Page 3 of Mrs. Aladdin's paper. He said, one, be a genuine child of God. How many of us are Christians here? How many of us are Christians? The first thing you become before being a priest. Being a Christian. So in the seminary, they will tell you, if you are a Christian, drop it as a baby. And Baba Mutombe will tell you that. Baba Matthew will tell you that. If you are a Christian, drop it at the gate first. Now, enter the seminary. We will furnish you with some information that you will look at yourself. Am I a Christian? Are these people who are teaching us, are they Christians? And they are actually Christians. Some of them will even go, they are bishops. And they start to They start to teach you African traditional religion. And the man will be dishing out offer. I remember late Babani and Ruba. In the army, there are different departments. They have combatants, they have artillery, they have some of them that are very medical. Several! And I thank God for our government. We have several fields. So all those fields should be brought together. When the medical doctor is the vicar, you are only going to compound the problem. Because being a medical doctor, jealous profession itself. You now add it to have that jealous profession as a vicar. Yeah. I want my girlfriend who they have a jealous of you. I pity your brother when you were in the hospital, even as a assistant. The man will run from the hospital for one service. He said, hey, so what service you have provided the hospital room? And from the service, they will call him. Some of us, our gift is supposed to be manifested as assisting priest. But we clamor to become vicar. When we become vicar, we become useless. God will give us understanding. Now, let us look at another thing. He says, Mr. Larry said, handling every case identified carefully with the wisdom of God and help your husband. And I ask you to help your wife. Most of our wives are in charge of women in the church. Both of us transfer. Now, Baba mentioned something in his paper. Yes, in his keynote address, page 4 of it, and the second to the last paragraph, he said, let us ask ourselves today, what kind of feelings have we piling up in our being? What has been the impact of these feelings on our health? As clergymen and clergywives, we have to be careful about the kinds of emotions that we allow to settle into and accumulate in our psyche. The moment you lose hatred, that person is your colleague. The moment you lost hatred again, you are falling sick. Because some things will be secreted in your body. This gallbladder will secrete some of these gas. You won't be able to laugh again. I was hammering it. How often do you laugh? How often do you laugh? You won't be able to laugh again. In fact, you will withdraw. And I asked you yesterday, how many of you want to be here? Some of us don't want to be here. Why? We want to see that man again. I don't want to Some of us, we are good at it. When, because we don't know what to do that way, we can't do it. It's a lie. We are not receiving any more. Because we don't know to beat that. See, that man that you are seeing as somebody that has become to Allah for you, God has a purpose. The same God that wrote this book of Timothy that we are talking about, there was complaining that some people did not come and visit him in prison. He had an issue with one small boy, man. He said, no, you cannot stop us here. No, I don't like it. This. Yes, but that guy can say like this. But Mark followed the other man. He gained so much experience and God was able to give me back now. Give me back. I can see some things there. Oh. So, see, your organ's emotion can fluctuate. Even yourself, your emotion can fluctuate. So, we should try as much as possible to balance our emotion. The person that is good to you today may become worse tomorrow. Our expectations are high at times, so we should be careful with the expectation that we have. I pray God will give us understanding in the name of Jesus. Comment and contributions. Comments, questions, contributions. Yes, sir. By praising the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Well, the comment I have, I just have to revealing within me as that was teaching us.
Go have it within you. You watch your balance there.
And I know the living will really help us. I wanted to stop and not say it, but I didn't have peace in my heart, so I just have to say it so I can
have
peace. Amen. I want to believe that the fourth question on that one, is it possible to return to the drawing board? It is possible. No matter how far one is going on the wrong path, you cannot get to the right place until you turn. Despite your intercessory power or knowledge, you have to change. When we are called to come to the ministry, personally speaking, I didn't want to marry a pastor because I have so many. focus and set a goal that goal and regularly review it in prayer. Ẹ jẹ́ fi ọkàn kan bọ́ kọ wá lò. Ẹ jẹ́ àgbàdúrà fún ọkọ̀ kan tó kàn kí ṣe pé Ìbàdàn dúró inú ẹ̀ lọ́ṣọ̀. Because in that you will be the man that you can marry. Because Ọlọ́run tó fi ọkọ yẹn wá fi ẹ́ lọ́kàn. You don't need to go up in that bag of your own for that hour and a half. Torí adé nínú ìfúnni wa ta àgbájú ẹ̀. Ó lè tí ọkọ rẹ kúrò nínú kábíyèsí kí wọ́n wá lọ. Ó lè tó lọ nínú ọkọ rẹ wá jẹ́ kábíyèsí. Jẹ́ kọ́kọ́ rẹ jẹ́ kábíyèsí rẹ lórí.
Thank you. Any other? Yes, ma'am.
When you were talking about teamwork,
yes.
Now, if it happens, there's a party disagreement or whatever, like the example you gave about the footballers. Now, if it happens that way, is it not possible we call ourselves? I'm sorry, and then come together. If we do not do that, we should come to a sense of realization that after all, it may be the leader, it may be the younger one. So coming together and working together in the war, in the ministry, I think is very important. We should not be arrogant. We should not be full of ourselves. We should let God take over and take over. That is the only way we can be happy and we can. The first time you ask the question, how many of us are looking forward to coming to this? Me, oh, I always look forward to coming to this lady. I'm proud of it. Coming to this lady, and that was why I called my husband. Please, let us have time. So please, if you want to really move and you are that what you do, and you want to
most of the time, we no longer approach our
2 minutes. Just hold her and just remove that.
That's what we are talking about. What about if you can understand to say, my colleague coming out here, it is late. Bring our bonus keeper. Please, let's show we care. Being capable of the room, but without us.
Thank you, sir.
Brothers and brothers, you know, two terms I want to talk about. The first one is the fact that it is the church that I have found where fellows of this will keep you in the morning. Some of us have stayed long enough around. For those of you who are just coming, just left. What is going on there is we are in a school, so we learn everything together. The moment I said that, the promise looked at me, and he knew what I meant by that. We are colleagues, not friends. Pick these things. They are very, very fundamental. If you want to choose friends around here, be careful. You will shock your mouth that those who you call your friends are going to die. And who did that between yourself? Oh, you see, for me, human intelligence is very, very important. It says all things. Paul said, all things. Who all be everything together? He said, work together. But those who love God and are called. So if you have a focus, you have a focus. It is not in the church where wonders will never be shown. I beg you, brothers. And I'm asked, the what you can do for any of us, you feel irritated, you feel angry, and you feel anyhow about what has happened, please pray. Just pray. 1 Corinthians 4 7. Be careful. What is it you have? And have mercy. And if you have sinned, I will boast it. Let's be careful. Let's be careful. The same Paul tells us, he who thinks, that's your thought. You are even thinking. When you are empty, you think you are heavy. You know, he who thinks is nice. Come on, let's watch it. Let's take it. My brother is, we know ourselves. Even those who are new, they know some of us will forget here. And since they came,
very confident that the questions are here. Because all these questions are lawyer's questions. To answer it, you have to think deep. On behalf of the assistant and the entire clinic, and each people, and I will make use of what you have. I have talked to you. Thank you very much. May God bless you. Bless you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. God bless you. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for all that plans, the past 4 days, through the Bible study, various preachers. Grant us grace not to be hearers only. Grant us grace to be doers of your word. Father, we ask for more anointing upon our brother, the Reverend Kanoyeri. More and more, and all those who have led us in all service and lecture with the Holy Spirit, continue to bless all of us in your service as we go now for breakfast, let your presence go with us. All our sisters of the day, God, strengthen us by your mighty power. Thank you, Lord God, because you do more than we can ever ask for imagine. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please go for breakfast and more. God bless you. Well, expected back by 10 minutes past 10.